Hello, Zero K fans, and welcome to Nanolids at Dawn. I'm your host, Chet of Fury 333, with another set of exhibition matches for you. And this time we're going to start out with a match between Gaia and Xblade on Wanderlust, which is actually something that Gaia asked me to do. So, another request, like I said, always welcome. Also, before I start, I should point out a couple things. First off, for those of you not aware, Planet Wars has started up again. Planet Wars is a large-scale campaign-like thing. Basically, it's Clan Wars, but in the framework of a large multiplayer campaign. So you can go check that out. It's nice for 2v2, 3v3, playing around, having a nice bit of context to it. So if that's what's been keeping you from playing Zero K, is the lack of Planet Wars or lack of some kind of context to your battles, well, it's back. You can go back to play that. Also, next week there is a tournament. It is being run by Parzival, or Crow now, as they're known now. And it is going to be at 10 a.m. UTC, a 1v1 tournament, and looks like it's going to be a Swiss tournament for the first bit and double elimination for the top bit. Top four. Right, okay, they have actually specified that. So yeah, Swiss for everything up to top four and then double elimination for top four, and I realize that's a thing that has been a bit controversial. But hey, that is next week, so there's a tournament next week, and Planet Wars has started up in force. So, those are the announcements. Let's get to the game. So, Gaiop starting in the western side of the map with the Spider Factory, while Xblade with the Shield Factory over the right side of the map is doing Shield Factory stuff, like dirt bags. Because, as we established last time we saw Xblade strategies have not changed in the last 5 years. Although, in this case, thankfully for them, dirt bags are still a relatively useful unit for scouting. You don't actually see a lot of Shieldbot players use them, though. It's something that some people use, other people don't. It's not something I mean, I don't play Shieldbot myself much anyway, but I understand the value of them. Yeah, they're tough units, they kind of get in the way of things. They aren't going to be getting in the way of the Spider Factory, though, and actually most factories now actually have quite a few openings, so it's hard to lock them out with dirt bags. Still, though, good scouting. And at the same time, Gaiop with a few fleas, as is typical for the Spiderbot Factory. Gaiop just setting them up as a nice little ring around their opponent's base so they have some idea of when their opponent is expanding. Oh, nice! Never mind, Gaiop not just knowing when the opponent's expanding, able to figure out at least briefly what's going on there, but Xblade did spot that flea. Gaiop got a little bit greedy with their information, but still, they have the information they need around everything else. Gaiop's getting really greedy here. My goodness, these fleas! I mean, Gaiop's probably going to send more, but man, these fleas are getting killed and kind of don't have to. I mean, at this point, really all that needed to be done was to set up fleas in places where they'd either be able to get rid of metal extractors or constructors that are unprotected, so Xblade has to keep on their toes, or just know at least that their opponent is expanding in a certain direction, and then follow up with the Venom-Redback combo they're going for now, or at least the Redbacks they're going for now. Xblade, on the other hand, is setting up fairly defensively, going for rogues, which makes sense. They know they're fighting the Shieldbot Factory, and then skirmishers are a good idea there, especially with redbacks coming up. An Xblade looking to harass over to the north? Okay, Xblade surprisingly going over to the north. They are aware that the southern side is where Gaiop is. I'm guessing they're trying to go to the north to see if Gaiop has expanded over to the north, get rid of any easy expansions they can over to the northwest side of the map, and then sweep downward from there. That would make quite a bit of sense. Actually, this is quite clever. Xblade's now taking advantage of what's likely to be a weakness in their opponent, assuming that Gaiop expanded and that Gaiop wasn't sending their commander to expand as they actually are. But also, they have their rogue in a position that makes it clear that Xblade's not just sitting around. I mean, they're not just going to... Or sorry, they are potentially just sitting around. They're not making it clear whether or not they're sitting around or whether they're going out to actually attack. Not to mention, this is exactly where the rogue should be. So, Xblade positioning their units quite cleverly, getting the units they need. Should be able to deal with the redbacks as long as they don't get too close. That's the important thing. Don't get too close, you should be fine. If you get too close, you're done. That's always the thing you have to be careful about here. Getting too close is a great way to get yourself killed. At any rate, though, it looks like Gaiop is going to be able to get a little bit of a foothold here as Xblade push their rogues out of position. Not sure why they're going north with them. Seriously, what are they doing? Oh, they're on this fight move, that's why. They're not actually being sent in. That would explain the retreat behavior. Gaia being forced away. It looks like one of the Redbacks might go down. At the same time, this is the attack I was talking about over to the north. Exploit with all their bandits. The bandits should be able to get rid of this defender and possibly get rid of a metal extractor past the commander. They just need to get past the commander. That's the most important thing. And at this point, the Redback... Oh, one of the Redbacks... Both of them very heavily damaged. The rogues get them. That will open things up for the bandits. And no, these Redbacks are doing a wonderful job staying alive. Just barely. Ah, and one of them does go down ultimately. Gaia losing one of the Redbacks. But the important thing is that Exploit manages to get the bandits into the back line. There's hardly any defense. There's actually only one defender. There's the Weaver here. In the... Why is that not a target? I don't know. That needs to be the target. Like, that is the target of priority here. Get rid of that Weaver. Or the Caretaker, either way. Exploit going for the factory instead. Going for gold, but I don't think this is going to actually work. At least they finally went for the Weaver, and the Weaver won't kill them in the death explosion. So, oh, Weaver just barely surviving. Exploit not able to get anything out of that. You got to be super careful there. Although, admittedly, they didn't get anything out of that from the bandit attack, but they did get a great position with their rogues and bandits outside of Gaiop's base. I should also point out that Gaiop has actually been accessing this entire time and didn't have the energy for this, but that's clearly not the bigger deal. The bigger deal is the positioning. I mean, the number of units, yes, that's important, but at this point, it was just a matter of clever play by Exploit to distract Gaiop and then push into their base. I don't agree with attacking the factory, though. I still think attacking the factory is a bit of a mistake. I mean, it's working right now because the Caretaker is distracted, but once the Caretaker stops being distracted, it's going to be a lot harder to do successfully. That being said, it should be easy enough. It looks like there's enough firepower. It just doesn't matter. And once... No! What? No! Exploit! You had it! It's like, that was your goal, was get rid of the factory. And unfortunately, moving back, I can kind of see why, but it looks like it's primarily just that fight move. That's what fight move does. Exploit wasn't going through and figuring, oh, wait, this is what I need to do in order to win this. It's fight move to retreat, which... I mean, admittedly, Gaiop is still being contained pretty hard by Exploit. Exploit on the whole map, mostly over to the north, actually. Not really expanding over to the northeast or expanding to the center. They're expanding primarily to the north, essentially trying to cut off Gaiop to the north. And at this point, Exploit's doing a nice job containing, but I feel like this is a bit frail. Like, Gaiop's main problem here is that they haven't had enough build power to be able to get an army to push back against this. And they have the Recklesses coming up. I'm a bit surprised they don't have Hermits, though Hermits probably wouldn't do a great job here. Recklesses are not a bad idea. They just need more of them at once. That's what needs to happen. Get a few Recklesses, maybe get a Venom or two. I mean, not too many because the Venoms are countered by Rogues. This is the hard part about the Spiderbot factory. If you're dealing with Skirmishers, your options become a little bit more limited. Although Fleas are also really effective here. Like, that's actually a thing that would work beautifully. The Bandits, once they're gone, won't be able to help the Fleas, or won't be able to get rid of the Fleas, and then the Fleas can get rid of the Rogues, and that's the easiest way for Spiderbot to deal with Rogues. A Rogue Bandit mix, or similarly a Glaive Rocco mix, that's not easy, but a Rogue set on their own? Recklesses are not a bad idea, Fleas are an awesome idea, and at this point Gaiop has actually managed to recover nicely. They've got their factory back up to full HP, they have the commander nice and healed up. They don't have a huge economy though, but it is still roughly on par with Exploit, because like I said, Exploit was trying to cut off Gaiop to the north, but not actually really trying to expand everywhere. Not trying to take full advantage of the fact that really right now, Exploit has almost complete map control. Like, Exploit could get an extra 12 or 13 metal per second easily. And they are going for it, but a lot slower than I would have recommended. It just seems like they're much more focused on getting rid of Gaiop's main base than they are on getting rid of anything else. And no, this is actually not the same game as before. The last game we saw in Wanderlust, Exploit was playing the Spiderbot factory. And it was not even against Gaiop. So, no, this is actually a different game. Yes, last week I did do a Wanderlust game. That is fair. But it was Exploit and Rar that was playing. Rar was playing Shieldbot. Exploit was playing Spiders. And now Exploit's playing Shields and Gaiop's playing Spiders. And Gaiop's doing a much better job showing us what Spiders are supposed to do in this map and in this matchup. I still think they should be building some Fleas, but at any rate, the Recklesses are doing a good job. Like, the Recklesses are working to break the contain. There's enough defenses that if the bandits try to get too close, they are going to die. Unfortunately, the Recklesses are not in a great position, but they're in a good enough position. They aren't dying enough to make it a problem. They're, like, Gaiop's, they're falling behind economically, yes, but Exploit hasn't expanded quickly enough. Now, granted, this is more that Exploit hasn't expanded enough rather than that Gaiop is playing especially well. I still think Gaiop should be building more Fleas, but as it is, I mean, play the game that's get there, really. Like, Guyup just needs to keep going, because the way that exploit's been playing right now, Guyup should have no problem getting into a more even position once they break the contain. They have all this reclaim to work with, like, 1,000 metal worth of reclaim, and it's growing. This is a bit of a problem. I mean, the commander is actually in a bad spot right now, and of course, this set of rogues is still doing a number on Guyup's base. I mean, they're still sieging Guyup's base. It's not over yet. And the commander's only got 2 shots before they're dead. So they gotta be super careful. I would imagine that one of the caretakers should actually be repairing that. There we go. Guyup's on that. Getting that commander repair. There's the crab. There's the possibility of breaking this siege. The bandits trying to do what they can, but no, the crab is gonna be able to tear apart all these rogues. They're not even moving away from here. And even if they do, they won't move fast enough. The crab finally breaks the siege. There we go. Guyup should be able to break around the side, but look at Exploit right now. Exploit has managed to take advantage of the map control they got. They haven't taken advantage of all the production they need, though. They need a lot more energy. They're working on the fusion plant, so they've got that. It's a little late. They were still accessing, but given how much Guyup accessed before, it might still be even. And the important thing is that Exploit is still ahead. Guyup has about 1,000 metal worth of reclaim to get themselves back into the game, but that is absolutely necessary in order to do so. Thankfully, though, with the commander set up, they can start basically breaking all of what Exploit set up. I mean, Exploit's expansions across the map have been naked. Remember, there is the defense ranges up. This is the only set of defenders that's relevant. There are some lotuses over in the back, but basically the only static defense that's relevant is over here. All the units are inside of Exploit's base and streaming back into Guyup's to try to finish them off. Like, try to basically punish this insolence on Guyup's part. And Guyup, not gonna have any of it. Going for a missile launcher themselves. Ooh, I've never really seen someone go for a missile launcher on the commander. Rocket launchers, yes, but missile launchers, not so much. Mobile defender. That's actually a really good idea, given how there's no reload rate, so yeah, this is actually perfect. Guyup just needs to keep their commander alive. That's the important thing here. Keep your commander alive, and everything should work out. Actually, what's the range? Like, seriously, no one ever uses a missile launcher. Oh, 477 compared to, what, 500? 530, okay. So they're still outranged by the Roccos. But Roccos are a bit easy to dodge. Walk towards them and you dodge them. Unless they're being led. No, one more shot. This is not good. Down. Oh, Guyup losing their commander. They are unfortunately losing most of their metal from the loss of the commander. Thankfully for them, they didn't have a whole lot in storage. They had the energy in storage, yes, but not metal. And they just set up connection for the power plant, for the geo plant, so they do have overdrive, getting themselves back more or less on track, along with the reclaim. But losing the commander is a massive blow, and I think Exploit's going to take full advantage of that to get back in here. Really, the crab right now is Guyup's ace in the hole, and other than that, their main base is not doing great. You know, the bandit's coming in here. The redback should be able to save at least 2 of the weavers, and ooh, is it able? Yes, it is able to save actually all the weavers, just barely too. In one case, 10 HP left, but still, Guyup, how are you surviving this? Exploit, on the other hand, switching over to or adding gunships. Getting a bunch of gnats as well, because why not? I mean, if they're having a hard enough time as it is, but honestly, they're not having that hard of a time. I think they're gnatting the crab. That's probably the idea. Get the crab disarmed or stunned, actually. Come to think of it, gnats or EMP. But yeah, get the crab stunned. Stop it from doing anything, and then work from there. But at this point, I think Guyup should be out of here. Losing the storage again. Thankfully for them, they had backups on that one, so they're good for storage, but man, all these rockets coming in here should be able to take out the factory. And people were pointing out in chat that, yeah, factories do have a lot of HP. They have every factory has 4,000 HP, which, for reference, the rogues here deal about 280. They deal about 300 damage. So later on in the game, it works, but right now it doesn't. It's always more effective to go for the caretakers or workers or whatever. The factories are pretty much your last target in most cases. Going for the factory is a super gambly play. And here it is. There's the stuns. And it's actually working out okay. There's some... Okay, there we go. They have the stuns. We have the fire, though, from the Blast Wing. I think there was a bit of a mismatch here micro-wise, because Blast Wings do send fire high enough to burn out the gnats. So Exploit, unfortunately, stuffed themselves there by going in with the gnats and the Blast Wings as enough. But it's still going to be a bit of a problem, so that's a breath of fresh air for Guyup. They actually have 2 crabs now. They have a strong enough position that they can basically rebuild. I mean, they're still a bit behind Exploit. They have been most of this time. They did just lose their geoplant as well. Actually, that's a major blow. That is most of their energy economy, and they're going to need to rebuild that. And another Blastwing in an almost better spot. The Blastwing, if it was like right here, this spot right here, this is where the Blastwing needs to explode, because it would get rid of the Caretakers. Where it was used, it just stops the Gnats. Even Gaiup's trying to help out Exploit right now. But yeah, once again, the Blastwing's coming in here and destroying all the bandits. It's unfortunate, because, I mean, this wouldn't be a bad idea if it were for the Blastwings being used alongside the Gnats. If the Blastwings were used here, and the Gnats were used on the Crab, and then the... I mean, the problem with the Blastwings, of course, is that they are getting hit by the defenders as they come into range. So you have to send other units to distract them, to distract the defenders, before sending in the Blastwings, so the Blastwings explode when you want them to, rather than just arbitrarily, and then that'll work. But honestly, what Exploit should be doing with the money they have is getting rapiers. Get loads of rapiers or banshees. Either way, there isn't enough to deal with either in Gaiup space right now. So get banshees and rapiers, and then just tear everything to shreds. Gnats, banshees together work nicely. They're a little tricky, but if you get enough of both, it'll work. Like right now for a crab, I'd say probably about a dozen gnats and half a dozen to a dozen banshees would do the trick. Because the crab can't really deal with them, so we just stun it out and then the banshees just go to town. Once again, another set of Blastwings coming in here, all grouped up. It's Blastwings are a micro-sync. You have to be very careful how you're using them. And thankfully, we do see that Exploit is going for Banshees. But yeah, with Blastwings, you have to make sure you're microing them properly. And Exploit is basically just sending everything to one point. Like, grouping up, send to a point. And we all know how I feel about point move. And that's exactly what's happening. The Blastwings are detonated in the middle of everything because they're being hit by the defender. And then they splash each other. And then they all die. This is giving Gaiup all the opportunity they need to get out of here. And Exploit's commander in a bit of a tight spot. I don't think they're going to die. The Redback... Actually, wait, what? Holy crap, 45 HP. I was almost wrong there. Exploit's commander is not doing well, but Exploit themselves, they're their own worst enemy right now. Like, they're actually fighting for Gaiup the way that they're fighting right now. And as it is, also Racketeers too. Racketeers, as people are pointing out in the chat, as people are screaming in chat, Racketeers, yes! Racketeers are always the way to go. If you're playing Shieldbot Factory, when you deal with heavy units, get Racketeers. The advantage of Gnats compared to Racketeers is that with a Gnat, you get stun, you get EMP rather than just disarm, so you also lock the unit in place. And I don't recall, I think with Crabs, it keeps them in whatever state they're in armor-wise. I don't think it takes them out of their armored state. But Racketeers are also a really good idea. Like, either way, it's a great idea. And again, with the Blastwings, why? I don't understand why Exploit keeps doing this. Like, I get the first time maybe you don't understand that, yeah, okay, the Blastwings are gonna burn up your own units. But that was like over a dozen Blastwings and like 5 or 6 Banshees all together. All dead because of the Blastwings exploding. Actually, I think it was close to 18 Blastwings. It was loads and loads of Blastwings. The only thing, Exploit is going to be able to take this game only because they're building 32 Brawlers, which is not a great idea to build that many Brawlers, or that many of one unit in a chunk. But because they are doing so, they're not going to have Blastwings, and so they're not going to be killing themselves on this assault. I don't know if this is going to win them the game, but the fact that they're building so many Brawlers and no Blastwings is the best thing they're doing right now. Like, that is their best strategic decision they've made in the last 5 minutes. Oh, Aurelius, thank you for the tip. So, Aurelius is pointing out that disarm ignores the armor of crabs. Like, crabs, when they're locked up, it's hard to tell, but when they're closed up, they actually take a third the damage. So they have effectively 12,000 HP, and EMP is based on current HP. But disarm apparently is based on the actual value, whereas EMP is based on the value with the armor modification. Wait, Anarchid? No, Anarchid, okay, never mind, Anarchid's pointing that out. I've got to research that a bit. It's a weird interaction that doesn't come up that often. Like, people don't play spiders a huge amount, so the interaction between disarm and crabs isn't super common, and it's also not super well documented. So, yeah, I'm going to go with Anarchid in this one since they've probably done some actual dev work on that bit. Okay, Annika, thank you for clearing that up. So Annika clearing it up, it is capture is the only thing that ignores armor. So Dominatrix is the only unit that ignores the armor when it comes to any status effect based on, which is all of them, based on current HP. Every other status effect respects armor. Although, to be perfectly honest, I would kind of like it if when Crab switches, it just tripled their current HP and tripled their max HP, and then switch back, it just cuts their max and current HP by a third, or into a third of its form. So basically, it divides by three when it unpacks, and multiplies by three when it packs up. And there's some slight rounding errors that would occur, yes, but it would be a lot clearer that it's taking less damage for a reason, because it's the only unit, It and a couple turrets are the only units that do that. Like it, Faraday, Gauss, Razor. That's about it. No, there's another unit. I can't remember what the other one was. Oh, Anarchid. Okay, never mind. Anarchid pointing out a counter argument, which is that if Crabs showed their actual HP or the effective HP considering armor, it would make repair a lot harder, and then people would have to move them to repair them efficiently. That is a fair point. That is a fair counterpoint for Anarchid, although that could also be countered again by having repair be tripled in that case. Which I'll grant would be a noob trap more than anything, as Anarchid is pointing out, because it would mean that newbies would expect you have to move the crab to get it more efficiently, not realizing that they'd actually repair equally quickly when their crab is packed up. Sorry, when crab is unpacked. But yeah, anyway, that's a fair point. But I still think the fact that the 4,000 HP is not really 4,000 HP is still a bit confusing. And then how it interacts with status effects. Anyway, back to the game, though. Gaiup is managing to rebuild. They've taken back half the map. So they're in a strong position right now. Exploit's still trying to harass along the sides, but not actually managing to do all that much damage. There's the Razor in place. There's a Tarantula that's been messing with everything coming in there. The Racketeer is in place, finally. One Racketeer. But it's not really enough, so... Yeah, that's the thing, is this is not working out really well at all for Exploit. They're continuously being pushed behind. They had a great chance early on. Their main mistake was that they focused too hard on the factory, not enough on the workers or the caretakers. And then later on in the fight, they focused a bit too much on, again, the factory, not enough on everything else. They never really did any damage, that's my point. And then when they finally got into a position where they were at an advantage with air, they stuffed themselves by building blast wings and not microing them properly. And down goes Gaiup's first crab, so the second crab is still in position, I believe, over to the north. Wait, where's that crab gone off to? Honestly, it's not a big deal, though. Gaiup right now is in the position they needed to be in before. They have a strong economy, though a lot of it is reclaim-based. They also have a fairly strong army. All they need to do is get rid of this felon, and they should be basically in the clear. They're expanding nicely. Their weaver actually is in a terrible position right now. It's about to die, and that is Exploit finally killing off a worker they need to, as it's in a spot that it needs to be in. So that was a worthy sacrifice of bandits. As long as Exploit goes north and actually deals with that area as well. Because Exploit is currently on par with Gaiup. They're not falling behind yet. They haven't lost too much in that regard, but they still need to build up some stuff. Like, there's some metal extractors they could retake, like the one in the center. And otherwise, I guess, yeah, it's going to be reclaim and overdrive. That's not going to be as easy in Gaiup. They have far more reclaim to work with, what with Exploit constantly donating metal. And at this point, Gaiup, with all of everything, they've pushed all their production into their factory. They only have the one factory. They haven't even gotten a Strider Hub yet. They only have the one Spider Factory. But all the Recluses are doing a wonderful job getting rid of the Felons. It's exactly what they need. And the sheer number of Recluses is making it very difficult for Exploit to move around at all. One of the Felons is down. Honestly, the Felon has no support. It doesn't even matter. Anything could come in there. A few Fleas could come in there and take care of that Felon. It was so out of support. There was no shields left. And finally, Exploit's Cavalry arrives, but way too late. Another Felon is in position, though, and it should be helpful, but... I mean, look at this. Exploit's energy right now. They're losing 24 energy per second to these two shield generators, and it's clearly way too much. Or no, that's not... Never mind. Sorry, no. They're overdriving. They're fine. It's overdrive. It's nothing else. But even then, it kind of sucks they're not getting any energy... Right, that's the thing I need to do. The spectator panels need to update when there's no storage because the commander's dead. Because Exploit's commander is dead. That's what it is. I feel so silly. Exploits Commander would have died a while ago, actually. Ah. So at this point, yeah, Exploit has no commander, has no storage. The spectator panels really need to be set up for that. I guess I could do that. But the... yeah, but overall, this is turning around. Guy Up has the units they need. Exploit... I mean, the Racketeers aren't going to be that useful anymore. There's way too many units on Guy Up's side, so that's not going to work. What would be needed right now are bandits. Loads and loads of bandits. And Exploit is going for bandits. They're also going for a crow, which explains where most of their money's been going. Actually, the vast majority of their money. In a minute or so, that'll come out and probably die with a sheer number of tarantulas here. Because tarantulas deal... like, that'd be 1,000... oh, okay, 220 per shot. That's 1,540 for the entire group here per volley, I should point out. And this thing only has 16,000 HP. So that'd be like 10 volleys, and each volley comes up once every 2 seconds. Yeah, it's going to survive for 20 seconds. Of course, that being said, now the bandits are coming fast enough. I mean, you would think bandits would clean this up, but with all the build power going to the crow, there aren't enough bandits. Here's how many bandits there are. 3! One of which just finished. That is the total number of bandits on this map. Both belonging to Exploit and Guy Up, of which Guy Up has none. So yeah, 3. That's it. There are no bandits, effectively. And I mean, as it is, we have... you know, like... I don't know, 3 of the tarantulas coming forward? Well, I mean, that's... no, that's... they're further up here. Yeah, the tarantula's in a nice line here, getting rid of all the spy planes. And the crow is... being clever. In a suicidal kind of way. Exploit going around the back, trying to hit the main base, trying to go for the factory. Maybe, just maybe, if they're lucky, they'll actually manage to kill the factory for once. But I don't think it's going to be relevant. Oh, wait. This guy has got spy planes. What am I thinking? I'm being silly. Still, the crow finally in position. But it's not really going to matter. And here it is. The crow's going to go for it. The crow actually... will be able to deal some damage to the main base. Okay, and are you going to throw the deagon at the right time? It's now. No. Okay, there it is. Sheesh, Exploit had Avengers on the spider, and the spider factory's still not dead! That spider factory has gone down below 1,000 health 3 times this match, and it's still not dead. And the crow is still on track to die. At least the caretakers died this time. And the spider factory finally goes down. Exploit's entire goal from 25 minutes ago has finally been accomplished at the cost of a unit that costs that reclaims for 3 times as much as the factory is worth. So, like, the crow just... Exploit just donated 3 factories worth of metal to get rid of one. But hey, they got rid of the spider factory. They've been trying to do that all game. They finally succeeded. At least they got the small win. Oh wow, Exploit had loads more metal. It really was a question of what units were being built. Like, that early crab really did the trick for Guy Up to push out. Like, that was what they needed. They needed the crab. They needed to have that set up so they can get everything else. Just to get some breathing room, because Exploit had a really good choice of units. The rogues early on were awesome. The only mistake they made was that they weren't targeting the stuff, they weren't targeting metal extractors, workers, and caretakers. They were targeting the factory, and exclusively the factory. If they targeted the commander, that would have helped as well. At that stage in the game, it would have been extremely powerful. And Exploit's distraction play, that was great. It's just once that fell apart, I don't think they had anything else in mind. They had a great early play, and then after that, the crabs came in, and they didn't have anything to deal with that, because they didn't build racketeers. And instead they built a bunch of blast wings, and then that wasted everything. So yeah, it was like, they were doing great, and then they faltered terribly. So yeah, Excess was relatively similar though, come to think of it. Like, throughout the beginning, Guy Up excessed more, as I pointed out, and then Exploit had some energy issues, and then kind of went back and forth. Still, that's a lot of excess. For a 25-minute game, 5,000 excess, that's fair, that's on the higher end. It's not ridiculously high, but it is in the higher end. But yeah, like, Exploit was doing... this is what I mean. This is where the rogues were doing a wonderful job keeping Guy Up contained in their base, and the bandits were doing their whole thing, keeping Guy Up's north expansion from not even happening. And then the crabs came out, and then the blast wings came out, and then there wasn't much left to say about it. Or, yeah, okay, I mean, the fusions were a thing. Like, there's a lot of good targets. The factories aren't one of them. Factories are the worst target. They have... They're worth 600 metal. They cost 600 metal. They have 4,000 HP compared to, say, a factory which costs 1,000 has 2,000 HP, or caretakers which cost about half as much as a factory and have 500 HP. Or a third of the cost of a factory and have 500 HP. And are as powerful construction-wise. The only thing they don't have is the flexibility of what unit they're helping to build. So if you kill off all the caretakers and workers, the factory can only build so quickly. And you can pretty easily, if you have a siege on your opponent's base, you can pretty easily take that out after you've taken out the rest of the units they have. Unless they're building some massive unit, like a crab, but that didn't come up until later, it's not worth going for the factory that much. Especially not if you don't commit to it, which is the other problem, is that the rogues were going for the factory, and then hitting it, and gutting it down to like 500 HP, and then retreating, even though there was more than enough of them to fire a couple more shots off, hit the factory, kill it, and then cut off Guy out from being able to build reinforcements for a minute. Which would have been enough. That would have probably given the game to exploit right there, 20 minutes ago. But instead that happened, and Guy up managed to take it back, and a lot of that was just exploit not picking the right units when they had the economic advantage, which they had for the majority of the game. Oh, there it is, yeah. Anyway, next game is going to be another request, actually, and it will be between Dimefreund and Google Frog. So stay tuned for that. It'll be up in a couple minutes.